ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، نعم المولى ونعم النصير. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا وطبيب نفوسنا وشفيع ذنوبنا ومولانا أبي القاسم محمد. والصلاة والسلام على أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين المنتخبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. رحمة الله على أحبابهم وأصحابهم وشيعتهم ومواليهم أجمعين، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم وظالميهم ملعونين من يوم عداوتهم وظلمهم إلى أبد الآبدين. إذا شئت النجاة فزور حسينا، إذا شئت النجاة فزور حسينا لكي تلك الإله قرير عيني، فإن النار ليس تمس جسما عليه غبار زوار الحسين. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your ibadat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your efforts towards the day of Arba'een. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the fact that you have respected and honored this sacred day of Imam al-Husayn in the remembrance of the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Today you have gathered here to commemorate the 40th of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salatu wa salam, most popularly known as Al-Arba'een. They say that the day of Arba'een of Imam al-Husayn is when the first Zair of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn came to Karbala, Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari. The narrations say that he was alone from Medina to Kufa. He left Medina on his own. He was very old at that time, and he had lost his eyesight according to some traditions. And he traveled alone from Medina to Kufa. Now this is a journey that Muslim ibn Aqil, who was 35 years old at that time, when he made this journey, not from Medina, but from Mecca, or close to Mecca, when he made this journey, He was accompanied with a few of his friends as well. But even being young at that time and even being with proper guides, he barely made it to Kufa. He was at the brink of death, as they say, when they found him and brought him to Kufa. And this is the journey that Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari did alone, walking from Medina to Kufa, and from Kufa, then he had a companion with him who took him to Karbala. As the companion, this companion knew where the grave of Imam Hussein was. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. The ziyarat of Imam al-Hussein has many fada'il in the tradition. In ahadith, many things have been narrated. I had planned to talk about pretty much all of them in this piece today, but alhamdulillah, we did something much better. We had the walk, and mashallah, we spread the message of unity, and we performed the form of worship, which is much greater than I had in my mind and I had imagined. And alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept that the walk of you all. And for the qabuliyat of that, please recite aloud salawat. The narrations say, ما بين قبر الحسين إلى السماء مختلف الملائكة. From the grave of Imam al-Hussein all the way to heavens, this space in between is a space where angels come and go. Where angels come and go. The narrations say every evening 70,000 angels descend from heaven and they come to Baytullah, Makkatul Mukarram. All night they do tawaf of Baytullah. And at the time of dawn, Fajr, they come to the grave of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salatu wa salam, and they cry for Imam al-Hussein alayhi salatu wa salam. They do the ziyarah of the qabr of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salatu wa salam. And at that time, when they are done, when the sun is about to come up, they go back to heaven, and another batch of 70,000 angels descends at the sunrise, comes down to Baytullah, does the tawaf all day long, and close to Maghrib, close to the sunset, they come to the grave of Imam al-Hussein, and they stay there, do the ziyarah of the qabr of Imam al-Hussein, and they cry for Imam al-Hussein, and then they ascend to heaven, and another batch comes down. The narration say the 70,000 that come down, they never get a chance to come back again. Every time the batch that comes down is the new one. There were 4,000 angels, according to narrations, 4,000 angels who begged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Ashur, begged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send us down so we can help the grandson of Imam al-Hussein in Karbala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them permission, you are permitted to go down. But they came down and they seek permission from Imam al-Hussein. The narration says that Imam al-Hussein said that I will not fight this battle with any supernatural force or any help that is beyond the understanding of human beings. I will fight this battle with what I have in my hands and what I can control here in this world. And these 4,000 angels did not go back. They stayed there and they saw the whole ordeal. What happened in Karbala? He him sacrificing his companion, sacrificing his nephew, sacrificing his brothers, sacrificing his sons, the son who is 18 years old, the son who is 6 months old, the nephew who is 12 years old, the nephews who are 7 and 8 years old. They saw all this. And at the end, they saw that he is left alone. He looks at the right and he looks at the left. He calls for help and no human comes to help him. And there are 30,000 soldiers standing in front of him. These angels can see all that. And they saw the whole ordeal. And they saw the slaughtering of the son of, or grandson of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. But the moment it happened, when Imam al-Hussein was killed, these 4,000 angels were the first one amongst the angels who were there at the grave of Imam al-Hussein. These angels took the dust from Karbala and made themselves muddy. And since that day till now, until the day of judgment, they will be crying on the grave of Aba Abdullah. They will be praying for the people who are visiting Aba Abdullah, no matter when they visit, whether it is in the morning, in the evening, no matter what part of the year they come to visit Aba Abdullah, these 4,000 angels, they pray for the Zuwar of Imam al-Hussein. The narration says that when a Zair, a visitor of Aba Abdullah, leaves his home, he performs the ghusl and leaves his home with the intention of visiting the grave of Aba Abdullah. The narration says when he takes the first step, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم. Rasulullah, when sees this person take the first step, he says, glad tidings to you, and there is a good news for you. You will be with me and my family as a neighbor in heaven. He takes the second step and the voice comes of Amirul Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, who says that from now on you do not need to worry about your needs in the world. I will take care of them. And for every step of the way, he receives the reward of doing Hajj and Umrah. And in some narrations, his sins are forgiven, and many of the hasanat are written in his Namay A'mal. The narration say when he leaves the house, 70,000 angels surround him and protect him and take him and stay with him until he reaches the grave of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. And when he reaches there and performs the ziyarah of Aba Abdullah, these angels are praying for him. And when he's done doing the ziyarah of Aba Abdullah, these angels congratulate this person that all your sins are forgiven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it wajib upon himself that he will most definitely let you enter in Jannah, in the heaven. Jannah has become wajib on you. Heaven has become obligatory on you. And it doesn't end there. He said this person, when he leaves to go back home, these angels accompany him and they come back with him to his home. And when he reaches his home, the angels stay there for a day or two. And then they come back, and then it doesn't end there. the angels, whenever they find out that the person is sick, they come to visit him and to see how he is doing, and they stand by his bed and they pray for him until he recovers, then they go back again. And the narration say that when this person finally dies and leaves the earth, leaves this world, these angels come and stand in his janazah, in his funeral. They come and they pray on him and they stay with him until he is buried, and then afterwards they go back. Yes, but till the day of judgment, they keep praying for the forgiveness of this person's sins. Plus, they do the ziyarah of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein every day, and they gift the thawab of that ziyarah to this person who was the zayr of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Do you understand the significance of walking towards the mashhad, the shrine of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein? Why is it so important for us to visit Aba Abdullah? There are many lessons for us in Aba Abdullah. There are thousands and thousands of sources of guidance just in the personality of Aba Abdullah for us. We need to learn, we need to find a way to pinpoint those things that we need in our life to fix ourselves. We need to be good Husseinis. We need to be good Husseinis if we want to be good humans. We need to be good Husseini if we want to be decent human beings and caring human beings and loving human beings. We need to be good Husseinis if we want a better afterlife for us. It was not easy for the family of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wa salam to sacrifice all those things. They did so to save the humanity. They did so to save us from the darkness. They did so to save us from tyranny. They did so to save us from the life of continuous sinning. And they did so to be hope, a lantern of guidance for us throughout our lives till the day of judgment. As long as there is the name of Hussein alayhi salatu wasalam in the world, we will find people always finding their way home, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari comes to Kufa and he finds someone by the name of Atiyah al-Awfi. He says to Atiyah, take me to the grave of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. They leave Kufa and they start walking towards Karbala. And when they reach Karbala, when they are close to Karbala, Jabir says, are we close? And Atiyah says, yes, we are very close. He says, do not take me to the grave of Aba Abdullah right away. Take me to this stream of water that I've heard. There is a nahar here. There's a river close by. I want you to take me there first. So Atiyah al-Awfi takes him there. He takes him to that nahar. And he performs ghusl. He performs ghusl. And he has two pieces of cloth with him. And what he does is, just like when we go to Hajj, we put one around our waist and we put the other one around our shoulders. He puts one shroud around his waist and the other one around his shoulder after performing ghusl. And then he asks Atiyah, do you have any itr, any perfume? He says, yes, I have. He says, give it to me. He takes that عطر and he puts it on himself and very slowly takes the step towards the grave of Aba Abdullah. He cannot see where he's going, so Atiyah al-Awfi is helping him. He takes the first step, he says, Allahu Akbar. He takes another step, says, Allahu Akbar. He takes another step, says, Allahu Akbar. He keeps moving forward. He keeps moving forward and he comes to the grave of Aba Abdullah. Atiyah al-Awfi says, we are at the grave of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn. I wonder if he had asked him, how do you know that this is the grave of Aba Abdullah? Atiyah al-Awfi must have said at that time, it says so at the grave, it is carved so at the grave. هَذَا قَبْرُ الْحُسَيْنِ هَذَا قَبْرُ الْحُسَيْنِ بْنُ عَلِيِّ الَّذِي قَتَلُوهُ عَطْشَانًا. The moment he's told that this is the grave of Imam al-Husayn, he throws himself at the grave in the form that he's trying to hug Imam al-Husayn through that grave. He throws himself, the chest is on the grave, he puts his cheek on the grave and starts crying, and the narration say that he loses consciousness. Atiyah al-Awfi has to put some water on his face to bring him back to consciousness, and then when he wakes up, he starts crying hysterically and he says, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein. And then, as if as he is waiting for the reply to come from Aba Abdullah, it says, حبيب لا يجيب حبيب. Why is a Habib? Why is my friend? Why is a friend not answering his own friend? And then he answers his question himself. How can you answer? Your veins from your neck are lying on your shoulders, and your head has been severed from your body and is far away from here. The one who has no head on his shoulder, how can he reply my calling? Then he does his ziyarat of Shuhada'i Karbala, and then he gets up. Atiyah al-Awfi comes to him and he says that I see a group of people coming from the direction of Sham. He says that go quickly check who these people are. If these are the people of Ibn Ziyad, then come back and tell me and we will find a place to hide. I do not want to confront them. And if it is my Imam Zainul Abidin, then come and let me know so I can go and throw myself at his feet. Atiyah al-Awfi goes and he finds out that this is the usara of Ahlul Bayt. Imam Zainul Abidin is coming. He rushes back to Jabir bin Abdullah al-Ansari. قم يا جابر إلا علي ابن الحسين قد قبل ذا سنة حسين المظلوم علي زين العابدين has arrived. Jabir cannot control himself. He rushes towards Imam Zayn al-Abidi. Atiyah tries to control him, but he is rushing. He reaches close to Imam Zayn al-Abidi. He throws himself in the feet of Imam. السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله السلام عليك يا ابن الحسين المظلوم الشقيق إمام زين العابد
tears. He looks down to Jabir. He says, "Anta Jabir? Are you Jabir?" Jabir says, "Na'am, ya ibn Rasulillah." Yes, oh grandson of Rasulillah, I am Jabir. Ya Jabir. Imam crying hysterically and says, "Ya Jabir, hakuna qutilat rijaluna." And this is where they slaughtered our men. Hakuna dhubihat atfaluna. And this is where they slaughtered our children. Hakuna subiyat nisauna. This is where our women were held captive. And this is where hakuna uhriqat khiyamuna. And this is where they burnt our tents. And then they go to the grave of Imam al-Hussein. Every lady before she goes to the grave of her own shaheed, they all come to the grave of Aba Abdullah crying and crying. There is a cry heard from Zainab al-Kubra. She says, "Ya Nazili Labi Karbala Ghal Indakum خبر بقتلانا وما أعلامها وما حال جثة ميت في أرضكم بقيت ثلاثا لا يزار مقامها." Oh people of Karbala, do you have any news of a body that lied there for 3 days and no one came to bury it, no one came to wash it, no one came to give kafan to it? Every lady is at the grave after this visiting Aba Abdullah. Now they go to the graves of their own sons, to their own graves of their own husbands, to the graves of Ashab, to the grave of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Umm Rubab, Umm Rubab, sallallahu alayhi Umm Rubab. She comes to, she's looking at right and left. She's trying to find a grave that is a small one. All the graves are big one, adult graves. She's looking for a grave that is a small grave. She looks at the right, she looks at the left. She cannot find a grave that is a small one. She comes to Imam Zainul Abidin. She very, in a very low voice, in a broken voice, tear falling from her eyes, and she asks, where is my son Ali al-Asghar buried? Where is my 6 months baby buried? Imam Zain al-Abidin, while crying, holds her hand and takes her to the grave of Aba Abdullah, puts her hand there and tells her, "Your son Ali al-Asghar, your 6 months old baby, is lying on the chest of his father Aba Abdullah."
سيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. رضا بقضائه وتسليما لأمره.
With the tears that you have in your eyes, with the broken hearts, let the light stay off. Let the light stay off for a while.
with the tears that you have in your eyes, with the broken hearts that you have in your chest. Right now where you sit, it's considered the land of Karbala. The roof that you sit under is considered Qubbatul Hussein. This is not according to me, this is according to Ayatollah Ja'far Shustri ala Allahu maqamahu. He says, whenever there is the azaa of Imam al-Hussein, the place becomes like the Qubba of Imam al-Hussein. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is wajib upon me when a person prays under the Qubba of Imam al-Hussein that I should accept his prayer sitting here. Remember your Imam, remember the Hussein of your time, and call him Ibn al-Hazal, Ya Ibn al-Hazal, Ya Ibn al-Hazal, louder, louder, Ya Ibn al-Hazal, Ya Ibn al-Hazal, Ya Ibn al-Hazal, comes out of your mouth, Imam is listening. When you say Ya Ibn al-Hazal, when you say Ya Sahib al-Asr wal-Zamal, when you say Ya Ibn al-Zahra, on every call he says Labbaik, Labbaik, Labbaik. Please all together say Ya Ibn al-Zahra, Ya Ibn al-Zahra, Ya Ibn al-Zahra, Ya Ibn al-Zahra. Allahumma kulli waliyika al-Hujjat ibn al-Hasan, salawatuka alayhi wa ala في هذه الساعة وفي كل الساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا. اللهم اجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه ومن شيعته وخدامه. نسألك اللهم زيادة في العلم. Everyone say إلهي أمين. اللهم إنا نسألك زيادة في العلم وبركة في الرزق وصحة في الجسم وطولا في العمر ونورا في القلب وطوبة قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت ومغفرة بعد الموت ونجاة من النار ودخولا في الجنة والعافية من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم احشرنا مع محمد وآل محمد. اللهم احشرنا مع محبي أهل البيت عليه السلام. اللهم احشرنا مع زوار الحسين عليه السلام. وصلى الله على محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات.